Hello, this is the second video tutorial related to the voxel modifier. In the last video, we have investigated how to use the voxel modifier inside the edit mode. But now, we are going to investigate how to set up the player so it can interact with the volumetric environment. Therefore, inside the asset package, there is a prefab called player, and we are going to drag it into the scene. Now here we have the player prefab, which has the controller, so it can move around. Then it has the canvas, where you can set the mode, ID value, the target dimension and radius. Here we have a script which is doing the particle visualization, so you know where you are modifying voxels. And then here is the event system, which is required for interaction, and also the raycasts. Here inside the FPS controller, we have here the scripts related to movement. Here is the voxel modifier. Here is the game controller, so we can move around. And here is a very important script which does the raycast, and this is called mouse to voxel. Now let's play around a little bit. Now I'm going to hit play. And the first thing we will notice is there is no voxel block, because this voxel generator has no save system, so it has absolutely no information saved inside the voxel block. Therefore we have to generate the block manually now. You can see I can move around with the Y, A, S and D button. And if I hold the control key, I can see here the visual indication. And if I press the left click, now I'm going to modify voxels. I can increase the radius. The sphere gets bigger. Also it gets, now it gets smaller. I can also increase the target dimension. Add in order to modify the material for the second dimension. And also, just for proof, so I can also collide with the environment. Now let's go back into the edit mode and investigate how this whole stuff is set up. So here we have the FPS controller, and now we are going to investigate the most important part, which is the mouse to voxel script. The first parameter it wants to have is the modifier. Voxel modifier can be assigned, or if it is on the same game object here, it will be fetched automatically. Then it requires a source camera, which is the first person camera for the character, because this is the origin of the raycast. Then we have here the target point for the indicator, and here we can define the target layer for the raycast, also activation button. Here at last is a limiter for a distance, so you cannot modify voxels which are very, very far away. And this is everything you need in order to modify voxels inside the game. Now at last, it is probably possible that you are going to implement your own setup. Therefore, we are going to investigate the voxel modifier inside the scripting environment. Here we have the voxel modifier script, and the most important function is modify at pause, where you only give the position, that your world position, as input parameter. And here you have the another function where you can add an override for the radius, but I recommend to use the first one, because the first one uses the parameters set inside the default settings of the voxel modifier, which is the target dimension, depth, ID, the mode, and the shape settings, which are defined here. So you only need the position, and everything else is defined inside the voxel modifier. Also, here are other scripts where you can set the ID, the radius, what is the mode, by using the Unity visual scripting system. For example, you can drag this function here inside the button, in the UI for the button setup, and bind it so it changes the value when you click on the button, which is implemented here for the modes. Let's investigate them a little bit. Here, for example, is a button, and here when I click it, it is will call the function voxel modifier point set modification mode, and it will set the value to 1, which is add. Let's check it again. Here we have the ID. Here is it? It's the correct function. Here, when we check out the modes, this is 0, this is 1. Therefore, if I click on add, it sets the value, the modification mode, to additive. So you can implement your own systems which uses the voxel modifier, for example bombs or a rocket or something else which modifies the voxel on impact, for example. And this is the best way to modify voxels using simple spheres. Can be creative, and that's it. That's how to modify voxels inside the Unity game. And now you are able, after watching these videos, create your own game using the voxel generator and the voxel modifier. But one last thing is missing, because we have now had to create the voxel generator in game by manually clicking on the generate button, because it has no save system. Therefore, in the next video, we are going to investigate the save system and how to use it.